Dude, I don't want any porosity, no bubbles, no nothing in my pressure die castings. Just the metal, okay? You got it? What, you want no porosity in your die castings? Ugh. Have you ever wished that your pressure die castings had absolutely no porosity in them? Well, sadly, porosity is just a fact of life, but today we're going to discuss how product developers can work with their suppliers to minimize the problem. We're also going to explain the difference between short shots, entrained air, and vacuum bubbles. So take a deep breath of air, hold it in, and enjoy this high pressure episode of Serious Engineering for Serious Engineers. The first type of porosity is called a short shot. Although it's technically not porosity, it is a real pain and it's made up of air, at least whilst it's still in the mold, but arguably it's the easiest to deal with. Short shots usually occur when there's not enough pressure or speed to get the aluminium out into the farthest reaches of the cavity before it freezes off. One solution is to play around with the injection parameters and maybe even add some additional overflows and venting. Another is to consider increasing the wall thicknesses of the part, which gives more room for the material to flow. The optimum wall thickness is between 2 and 3 millimeters. So that's the easy one out of the way. The second type is entrainment of air. Entrainment is the enveloping of air that is already in the die or even in the shot chamber during injection. It's a bit like when you're trying to drink a glass of water quickly and you gulp down a load of air at the same time. Very annoying. The way to avoid this is to ensure that there are no obstructions in the die, as I mentioned in our previous video, link here. Another way is to ensure that you position the gate such that the material stands the best chance of flowing through the whole part without jetting over holes in the die or jetting perpendicular to heat exchanger fins, for example. If you work closely with your PDC supplier, they can run a simulation tool such as MagmaSoft, which is the PDC equivalent of mold flow, which of course is for plastic injection molding. They can then tell you where you're going to have problems long before the design is fixed. How else can you get rid of entrained air? Well, in the past, people experimented by filling the die with oxygen, and therefore all of the entrained gases would be oxygen, and that would react violently with the molten aluminium and form all sorts of oxides and other compounds, and thereby turn the gases into solids. This would leave a vacuum, which then collapses, pulling the molten aluminium in on itself. It did work, but as you can imagine, it's extremely dangerous. And to quote a famous CNC YouTube star from America, boom! And that's why very few companies still offer that, presumably because they burn to the ground. One technique that is still used is to pull a vacuum in the die, which also helps to suck the air out as the aluminium advances. Again, this is highly impractical and frankly, it's better to just redesign the part and the die to avoid entrainment in the first place, or push the problem to a place on the casting where it doesn't matter. Again, consult your PDC supplier during the design phase. Now let's talk about number three, vacuum bubbles. Vacuum bubbles occur once the die is filled and during the holding stage of injection. The surfaces of the part have already frozen off, but between those surfaces, you still have liquid aluminium and later slush phase aluminium that is still crystallizing and shrinking. And don't forget that this is all happening in a matter of milliseconds. Once the hold pressure is not enough to backfill the slush, the pressure drops as the material on the inside tries to shrink. And there comes a point where it cannot pull the walls together or cannot pull material in from the surrounding casting, and eventually that pressure drop is so great that vacuum bubbles form out of nothing. Those vacuum bubbles do, however, fill up with gases such as nitrogen from the surrounding metal, so technically they are not wholly vacuous. If we do nothing to mitigate these vacuum bubbles, you're going to get around 8% porosity by volume. The way that you reduce vacuum porosity is to add silicon to the molten aluminium. The more you add, the less vacuum porosity you get, but there is a practical limit. Now, the problem with silicon is that it makes the casting more brittle the more you add. So yes, you could get porosity down very, very low, but the casting would easily break. The sweet spot is adding somewhere between 9 and 11% of silicon, and that will reduce your vacuum-related porosity down to about 3.5%. So please don't ask for 0% porosity unless you want a box filled with aluminium chips. Here now are the two most popular and highly recommended aluminium alloys that will help you to avoid vacuum bubbles. And yes, I'm pretty much repeating what I said in the last video on this subject. ADC10 and its equivalent A380 have between 7.5% and 9.5% silicon, and this alloy is one of the most popular and widely used throughout industry. Its close cousin is ADC12 and its equivalent A383, which has between 9.5% and 11.5% silicon. So the silicon is right in the sweet spot and will give you around 3.5% vacuum bubbles. ADC12 also offers slightly better filling characteristics and resistance to hot cracking compared to ADC10. So ADC12 is pretty much the go-to for almost all applications worldwide. So there we have it. The big takeaways from this video are, number one, short shots are definitely not acceptable and relatively easy to fix. Number two, entrained air can be managed, and if not completely avoided, you can aim to get the entrained air into areas of the casting where the structural integrity is not a problem. And number three, you cannot completely get rid of vacuum bubbles, if you want strong castings at least, but if you use ADC12, aka A383, the very best you can ask for is about 3.5% porosity by volume. If you're experiencing problems with your pressure die casting development, don't forget that we're here to support you, so drop us a line. So that's all we have time for today. Don't forget to subscribe, share the engineering love, and punch like, or Barry will kick your ass. And don't forget, we're the people that do serious engineering for serious engineers.
Serious engineering.